Hello there. My name is Dr. Anton Jessup, curator of monster studies here at the university. Having recently reclaimed my classroom, I'm no longer bound by the crushing confines of the university basement and can turn my attention to specimens far more fearsome, far more godlike than anything I've vivisected before. So without further ado, class, let's turn our attention to this horrifying specimen. Oh yes, I speak of Kaiju, titanic monsters that emerge from ocean depths, descend from alien worlds, and evolve within the unnatural ecosystems of Monster Island, Skull Island, and various other hotbeds of severe island gigantism. In order to study these ferocious giants, I recently acquired a Minya, or Godzuki, the adorable and easy to manage larval form of that greater being, that king of kaiju you may know as Gojira or Godzilla. This monstrous avatar of destruction emerges from the ocean, levels cities with its ever-growing bulk, and most impressive of all, decimates adversaries both human and inhuman with its cataclysmic atomic breath. As one recent incarnation made obvious, Godzilla and his fellow massive unidentified terrestrial organisms, or MUTOs, are not denizens of our world. These rampaging megabeasts are radiation-feeding leftovers from a primal terrestrial era.
Oh, what a specimen! And interestingly enough, a radiation-eating Godzilla would not be alone in our world. According to a 2007 study from Yeshiva University, certain fungi could, well, not you, new kid, though you are a very fun guy.
Cause fun.
No. Certain fungi, as in fungus, have been known to consume radiation as a food source.
The researchers found that radiotrophic fungi containing the pigment melanin can utilize the ionizing radiation portion of the electromagnetic spectrum to transform gamma radiation into biological energy. This would be in keeping with the way chlorophyll in plants converts sunlight into bioenergy. Reports from the early 90s of melanin-rich fungi thriving on Chernobyl's reactor walls inspired the research, but the possible applications extend far beyond that. The researchers suggest that radiation-grown fungi might one day feed human space travelers on lengthy missions across the void. As for the notion that radioactivity might stimulate the immediate colossal growth of Godzilla, or even human beings like the amazing Colossal Man, the U.S. Department of Energy's Office of Human Radiation Experiments is quick to remind us that genetic mutation due to radiation does not produce the visible monstrosities of science fiction. It simply produces a greater frequency of the same mutations that occur continuously and spontaneously in nature. The natural world has produced no radioactive giants, at least of the animal kingdom, because the realm of plants is another matter entirely. Yes, in the wake of Chernobyl and other radioactive accidents, we have seen various malformations, including dwarfism, strange growths, glowing, and yes, even gigantism, specifically concerning pine needles. So sorry, CHUDs. You and the other animal mutants will have to stick to the sewers of the unnatural world, as well as the gutters of unfounded conspiracy theory.
Oh. It looks like our Godzuki has matured into a full-fledged adult Godzilla. Whoa, calm down there, big boy, calm down. Nobody leave. Look, if you need to smash a building, how about something from the College of Humanities? Or maybe the Dean's office. Maxwell, in transmission. All right then, class, you all know your homework for this evening. I want each and every one of you to be in here first thing tomorrow morning, impregnated with an alien embryo. You know what to do.